this video, we're going to show you how to complete the request for water analysis form. So grab your paperwork and let's get started. The first thing you'll see on your form is a red box. This is where the date and the time you collected your sample needs to be recorded. Please be sure it is the correct date and that you mark the AM and PM box for the time. If the day and time with AM or PM is missing, then we at the lab cannot ensure that it meets the time requirements and therefore cannot run the test. So please make sure you filled out this information. The next box you'll see is referring to hold times and thermal preservation. This box corresponds with the requirements laid out in the Safe Drinking Water Act. Please be aware that leaving this box blank means you agree to having your sample tested whether or not it meets all compliance requirements. That means the lab will run your sample and you will be charged. If you don't want that to happen, check this box on the form. That way, if your sample does not meet compliance for any reason, we will contact you and let you know. The next section is for sample collection information. First, you will see four sections with boxes. Leave these blank if you don't know the answers, but if you do, this does help us with internal data. The next section is for sample location information. Again, if you are unsure of what to put in this section, please just leave it blank. Don't worry, leaving the sections blank will not affect whether or not your sample is tested. Here you'll see a request for a WSSN. If you're a homeowner, you won't have a WSSN. This is a number a business would have. The most important parts of this section are completing the address of where the sample was taken, including your county, and filling in a correct sampling point of where the sample was taken. After that, you will be at the report results portion of the form. Here you will put your contact information along with your address and email that you wish to have the reports sent to. Please only provide one email, as our current system can only recognize one per report. Next is the billing information section. Here you will mark the very first box if your billing, name, and address are the same as the report results section above. Please be aware that we only accept check or money orders here at the lab. We do not accept cash. If you do not wish to pay with a check and you do not have a Drinking Water Lab account number, please provide an address so that we can send you a bill. The final portion is where you will select all the tests you wish to have done. Please mark the box next to the test you want or write it legibly on the lines below. If you are unsure of the tests that you need to have done, call your county health department and ask to speak to a sanitarian. They can help guide you in the right direction. Unfortunately, the lab staff cannot recommend any testing to the public under any circumstances. In addition, please be sure that you're using state laboratory bottles before you take your sample. We can only run tests out of the bottles that we send out for compliance purposes. If our sticker is not on the bottle, we cannot accept it, no exceptions. For samples requiring thermal preservation, we will provide ice packs. Be sure to freeze the ice packs for at least 24 hours before returning your sample to us, especially in the summer. Once you have finished completing your form, be sure to remove the yellow copy and keep it for your records. The back of the form will include a full list of sampling and shipping instructions. To learn more about drinking water analysis and the State of Michigan Drinking Water Laboratory, please visit our webpage. Thanks for watching.